figure out if everybody could have texture on there, could have, are you, atmosphere.
Those are not structures.
These are kind of radiating.
You're right.
Structure is a space.
Or this is random, kind of like.
He's got some dots here, trying to.
We're advanced planners, trying to narrow the market.
How to start thinking of the structure. This guy is, neighbors, they died, his house is like, oh my God.
Really?
Really?
And I'm supposed to worry about structure.
Narrative piece.
This is the worst.
Look at this big painting, we're looking at it like.
This is one of America's great paintings.
This one, so it's not like a painter of form, he's a painter of atmosphere.
Hostesses, yeah. Well, this is acrylic on canvas.
I think it restarted.
Where he takes two narratives, two different stories, and they don't always tell the same thing, they usually sort of tell the opposite, he'll never tell you what he's painting about, but they're always this kind of narrative that you, or incongruent styles or incongruent.
It's a feminist movement.
Yeah, all of these things, various positions, various.
He's always, you know, he's always talking about the female.
Okay, let's go this way. Let's go this way. So we have to read the title, I feel like I kind of.
Me too.
Because I was like, that's.
Really, I feel like it's a boat.
Going up the hill, and then we kind of read the biology.
You like, does you like anything in here?
Texture, I guess. Two things, quality is gravity of the leaves. Look at that red eye.
Francis Bacon was more, you know, like, active line and mark.
Just he just.
His story was about.
He did this years ago.
He was doing some training about life force, the energy.
Just so,
you know, this is Lucian Freud's friend.
Our back, they have studios.
And Francis Bacon from, they call him the British boy.
Oh, and here we have Tolstoy.
I don't even know.
He came when I was in school. He gets his figures really in the very tense.
The reference in the.
The head.
Look at that, it's just some very uncomfortable when he starts painting the mouth.
He's come back.
That creates tension in the ears.
I mean, I've had a lot of students, I taught the architect.
I do that, so I never feel that way. She taught, and my painters were much fun. What they would say to me, like we'd be talking about an idea, they'd go, just give me an amount of money and a square, like a lot, and I can build something out.
What are you going to build on it?
Can you stick with that?
Have you all applied for the MFA, I mean, the BFA?
That reference, the kind of work that you're doing, because, you know, it is kind of a scientific approach, you know, architectural approach, I should say, that an artist is too, because you are doing something.
What are the benefits?
Real.
This is definitely elevator.
No, it's a lot of trouble. What's that, he's in the elevator?
I think what you should do is you should.
And then you let go.
Own your perspective.
Deportations and.
Yeah.
So you need that structure. Painters are the most disciplined, musicians are very disciplined, artists are very disciplined. It's all thing that we're like, well, that's not true.
It already saved lives. You have done this, but you started this work. But this question is outside our temporary art. It's to save their lives. Because God told them to end it.
Yes.
Because there's some. They have to have just a survival mechanism.
Roger, there's a purpose, a role, and a responsibility that you have
are like rivers.
To do your best to be a part of the.
pool and we are dropping.
Feed that pool too.
You really don't know because you are part of the community.
Your ideas are collective, so there's no longer.
Always know, just meet Garrett somewhere, see how you feel.
Even though you're isolated in some way, like you are.
I'm kidding, his brother was sending him money, he was connecting him to everybody in Paris. He was nuts.
University system.
But his brother wasn't, so you need connection.
Well, I know my tribe.
My tribe, college. I flew all the way to New York to do my tribe. Cost a lot of money, you know, I can't ask that question.
He's trying to tell a story.
Are they all one story or are they all separate?
They're all separate.
You love chairs so much, why aren't there more chairs in the scene?
Not just a student.
Yeah.
I mean, a chair is an extension of your body, like in Iraq, you know, you sit on the floor. I mean, a chair, at least.
Because I really like to work cushions.
Sit on chairs. And in China, and I'm giving you three because that way you can, you know, all Mongolians, they still don't sit life-size.
All right.
A life-size chair.
So the chair three times.
And one of them can be just sent to one.
They can be without the first
one. So it is the person can just start.
The figures are very, to me, dying, you know, whole series of bathrobes that, you know, we did in class. And so, you know, chairs was the next thing. So bathrooms are us. Everything is an extension of our, you know, everyday kind of life in a chair. And you, the kind of chair you chose. So make them big, make them life-size.